Hello class 8 students, in the last video of chapter 16 our constitution we discussed about federal and unitary system of governance. Now same page 190 we shall discuss in this next video. In this video first of all we will discuss about, do you know, universal adult franchise, that is right to vote, was granted in 1950 to every citizen of India above the age of 21 years, but 61st amendment in 1988 lowered the age to 18 years. In our country India, universal adult franchise or universal suffrage was granted in 1950, but the age to cast vote was 21 years. In 1988, our constitution was amended for 61st time, and now 1988 onwards the age to cast vote is 18 years only. Now what is this universal adult franchise? Universal adult franchise is also called as universal suffrage. It means equal right to vote. Equal right to vote to each and every citizen of the country, irrespective of their differences. Irrespective of their differences means in our country different type of people live. They belong to different caste, their religion may be different, their language may be different. They belong to different regions, their custom, traditions and rituals are different, they eat different type of food and wear different type of cloth. People belong to different class, even you can see here, caste, color, class, religion or gender. Gender means male, female. Class means rich class, middle class, poor class. For all type of people there is equal right to vote, and the value of their vote is equal, whether they are rich or poor, male or female, they belong to any caste or religion. Their vote carries equal value, their vote has equal value. This is called universal adult franchise. Equal right to vote to every citizen, and each vote has equal value. Now second thing we shall discuss, single citizenship. In our country India, the citizen have single citizenship. They can belong to any state. If they are called Gujarati because they speak Gujarati and they belong to the state of Gujarat. The citizen here are called Marathi because they speak Marathi and they belong to the state of Maharashtra, but they do not have any citizenship as Marathi, Gujarati, Bihari, Jharkhandi like this. They have only one citizenship, that is they are the citizen of India. But if we take example of United States of America, there all the citizen have dual citizenship. They are all citizen of United States of America. Along with being the citizen of their country United States of America, they are all citizen of different states of America also. So in this way they have double citizenship or dual citizenship. So here we can see in India we have single citizenship. All the citizen are citizen of India only. They are, along with being citizen of India, we are not citizen of any other state, only we are citizen of India. Now next thing, single integrated judicial system. We have single integrated judicial system in our country India. We have three different levels of court. The apex. Apex means the topmost court is the Supreme Court. Just below Supreme Court, in all the states, we have high courts. And under high courts in all the states, in different districts, local courts are there. District courts or local courts are there. But their jurisdiction is not different. The lower level of courts function under supervision of the higher level of court. Integrated judicial system means the lower level of courts are not independent. They do not function independently. But the lower levels function under supervision of the upper levels of court. For example, the district court or the local courts function under control of, under supervision of the high court. And all the high courts also function under control or under supervision of the Supreme Court. So it is called that the judicial system of India is single and integrated. Single and integrated judicial system. Some important terms we will come across. Independent judiciary. Independent judiciary means that the judiciary in our country is independent to take its decision. The decisions of the judiciary, the decisions of the courts are not controlled by the executive, or it is not, decisions are not controlled by executive or legislature. Though the legislature has right to make law, the judiciary functions according to the laws made by the legislature. But legislature or executive organs of the government cannot control or dictate judiciary. The judiciary is independent to take all its decision. So it is said that in India, the judicial system is independent. Now, some more terms: fundamental rights, directive principles of state policy, and fundamental duties. We have 6 fundamental rights in our country. We shall learn about fundamental rights, directive principles of state policy, and fundamental duties in coming chapters also. We have 6 fundamental rights and 11 fundamental duties. Our fundamental duties guide us that what is our duty for our nation. We must perform 11 duties for our nation. And in the same way, our fundamental rights tell us that what are our basic rights, our fundamental rights granted to us by our nation, by our constitution. The fundamental rights and fundamental duties are supported by constitution. If we do not do our fundamental duties, we shall be punished. And if anybody tries to violate our fundamental rights, to take away our fundamental rights, the person will be punished by the court of justice. Directive principles of state policy direct us to follow some policies, but these are not guaranteed by the constitution. In next chapter, we shall be studying about fundamental rights, directive principles of state policy, and fundamental duties in detail. Now, chapter 16 is over. We shall be doing question answer in next video or through next assignments. Thank you, students, for listening and watching to the video so carefully. Thank you.